Hello students, till now we have studied different phyla. In those phyla, the organisms which comes under those phyla, they are all invertebrates, okay, or they are also called as non-chordates, okay. See, the phyla which we have studied from Porifera to the Echinodermata, so all the phyla which comes in between these two, that including Porifera up to the Echinodermata, all these are non-chordates, or they are also called as invertebrates. Okay, and one more phylum we are going to study today is the hemichordata. Okay, see, this hemichordata in the earlier days it is considered as subphylum of chordata. Okay, but nowadays it is kept under in a separate phylum with the non-chordates or with the invertebrates. Okay, see, today we are going to study one more phylum, that is hemichordata. Hemichordata, as I told you, in the earlier days the scientists considered these phylum as a subphylum in the chordates, but nowadays it is kept under the separate phylum. So that phylum belongs to the invertebrates, or it is considered as non-chordate. Okay, and this phylum, okay, it is the subphylum of non-chordates or invertebrates. Okay, it is a phylum comes under the invertebrates. Okay, as Echinodermata we studied now, so one more phylum that is included to the invertebrates or non-chordates, that is hemichordata. Okay, it is not the subphylum of chordata, but it is the phylum comes under the invertebrates or non-chordates. Okay, and this phylum is also considered as proto-chordates, or they are also called as pre-chordates. Okay, so this is called as pre-chordates, or they are also called as half-chordates. These are considered as half-chordates, or also they are called as pre-chordates. Pre-chordates. Okay. Pre-chordates are, they are also considered as half-chordates. And these are exclusively marine forms. These are exclusively marine. Okay, they are living in the sea or ocean. And these organisms are worm-like. These are worm-like organisms. These are worm-like. They look like worms. Okay. And these organisms are living in burrows. They are living in burrows. That means under the soil. Okay. Burrows. That too in U-shaped burrow. They live in U-shaped burrows. Okay. U-shaped burrows. Okay. And the body of these organisms, they are look like worms, and the body can be divided into three different parts. Body is divided into three major parts. Okay. First one is anterior part is called as proboscis. Anterior part is called as proboscis, and the middle one is called as collar. Okay, and the posterior part is called as trunk. Trunk. Okay, there is no tail present in these organisms. Okay, let me draw the diagram of the hemichordata. Example is balanoglossus. Okay, so this is the example for hemichordata. So let me write the diagram. So the triangular shaped structure that is called as proboscis. Proboscis, and it is extended by a slightly broad structure called as collar. Okay, slightly broader structure that is known as collar, and it is extended by, this one is extended by a elongated structure known as trunk. Okay, so this is the structure of the balanoglossus, which comes under the phylum Helicordata. Okay, see, this is called as proboscis, and this one is called as collar, and this is trunk. Okay, and this one is called as anus. Trunk region in the posterior end, it ends with an opening that is called as anus. So this is the structure of the balanoglossus that comes under the phylum Hemichordata. Okay, see, let me take the structure, let me explain the structures or the regions present in different parts of that body. Okay, so proboscis is there, no? So this proboscis contains mouth part, and also proboscis gland. It contains proboscis gland and also mouth. Okay, and this proboscis gland, it is helpful for excretion. This proboscis gland is called, it acts as glomerulus. And it is responsible for the excretion or the expulsion of waste products. Okay, so that's why it is related to excretion. They perform the function of excretion. Proboscis gland found in the region of proboscis. It is formed in the anterior part of the worm or that organism. That gland acts as excretion because it acts as glomerulus, and this glomerulus, it is responsible for the excretion of waste products from the body. Okay, and this collar region is there, no? That collar region, it contains a structure called as stomopod. Okay, the structure is called as stomopod. It is an outgrowth of buccal cavity. It is the outgrowth of buccal cavity. So that's why it is called as buccal diverticulum. It is called as buccal diverticulum. Okay, so a small outgrowth extends from the buccal cavity of this worm. So that is called as stomochar. Okay, so due to the outgrowth that is coming from the buccal cavity, so that is called as buccal diverticulum. Okay, so the scientists called this outgrowth of buccal cavity as little notochar. They called that outgrowth of buccal cavity as the little notochar, but it is not the actual or true notochar. Okay, so it is not the actual or true notochar. Okay, so even though it is not a notochar, but they named this outgrowth of buccal cavity as the notochar, little notochar. They named that outgrowth. Okay, but it is not the true notochar which is formed in this worms. Okay, so that is stomochar. That is not the notochar, that is stomochar. It is an outgrowth of buccal cavity. So that's why it is called as buccal diverticulum. Okay. See, this region is there, no? This region contains different parts. The trunk region contains different parts. So here tail is absent. Okay. Tail is absent here. There is no tail. Tail is absent. Okay. Tail is absent. See, this trunk region trunk part has different regions and different parts it has. Okay, the anterior part contains. Anterior part has branchial and genital region. Anterior part of trunk contains branchial and genital region. See, there is an outgrowth which is looks like a flap-like structure. Okay, so flap-like structure is found in the anterior part of the trunk. Okay, so in that region, in the anterior region, we find the branchial and genital region. Branchial region means it contains gills. Gills are present in the branchial region, and genital regions where you find the production of gonads, and gonads are found in that region. So that's why it is called as genital region. And this is called as hepatic region. Hepatic region, this is here some glands are found. Hepatic glands are found. Okay, and this region is called as abdominal region. Abdominal region. Abdominal region is one. Okay, so like this, trunk region of this worm contains three different regions. The anterior region contains the branchial and genital part, where the presence of gills, okay, we can see, and those gills are responsible for respiration. Okay, and genital region is responsible for the formation of gonads. Okay, and this hepatic region is found here. Okay, that is responsible for the formation of some glands are there in that region, and this is the abdominal region. Okay, and see collar region, we find the stomocaul, so it is an outgrowth of buccal cavity, so that's why it is called as buccal diverticulum. Okay, and here digestive system is complete. Digestive system is complete, that means it contains mouth and the anus. Okay, so proboscis region, mouth is present, so mouth is ventral. Mouth is ventral, that side. Okay, so mouth is ventral. So this worm contains both the openings, mouth and the anus. See, the organisms which contain both mouth and the anus, so in such organisms the digestive system is complete. Okay, so digestive system is complete in these organisms, and these are triploblastic, coelomates, bilaterally symmetrical, and they exhibit organ system level of organization. These are common, okay, common general characteristic features found in these organisms or in these worms. Okay, and next, the digestive system is complete. Let me erase this part. Okay, let me write the other general characteristic features. Okay, the digestive system is complete. Digestive system is complete. That means presence of mouth and anus. Okay, here, so that represents the complete digestive system. Okay, and next, respiration is through the branchioles that contains gills. Okay, respiration, branchial respiration. Branchial respiration takes place here. So this bronchi contains gills. So gills are the respiratory organs which are present in the branchial region. So that's why the respiration is called as branchial respiration. Okay. And then next, circulation. What about circulation? Circulation is open type. Open type of circulation we can see in these organisms. Open type of circulation. Open type of circulation formed in these organisms. These organisms contain somewhat developed blood vessels. The blood flows through the blood vessels, and they opens into, okay, the flowing blood vessels, that flowing blood, it opens into the openings are into the spaces, open spaces called as lacuna. Blood flows through blood vessels, flows through blood vessels and opens into the spaces, open spaces called lacuna. Okay, into open spaces called lacuna. There is no blood capillaries found in these organisms for the exchange of gases. Okay, this blood flows through into openings. Okay, so those are called as lacuna. Open spaces, then it flows, and then exchange of gases takes place in between the cells and the blood. Okay, through the diffusion process. Okay, and see, this is about the circulation. Next, the nervous system is like both in case of invertebrates and also in case of chordates, where we can see the nervous system here, the presence of ganglia. Okay, and also some nerve fibers are found in these organisms. Okay, nervous system resembles both the invertebrates or non-chordates and also the chordates here. Okay, and reproductive system, reproduction in these organisms, reproduction. So reproduction, and the sense here, these are unisexual organisms. These are unisexual organisms. Sexual reproduction occurs in these organisms. Fertilization is external here. Fertilization is external. Okay, and development is indirect. Development is indirect, and it has a larval stage called as tornaria. Fertilization is external. Development is indirect, including a larval stage, including a larval stage called as tornaria. Tornaria larva. Okay, so this is very very important. The name of the larvae. Okay, see, this development is including these organ. It is development indirect in these organisms, and that have a larval stage called as tornaria larva. Okay, and one more important thing we are going to study in this phylum. So this phylum, it is considered as a connecting link between. Okay, it is considered as connecting link between echinoderms and the chordates. Okay, see, this is very 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 important. So name the phylum which acts as connecting link between echinoderms and the chordates. So that phylum name is Hemichordata. It acts as connecting link between. It acts as connecting link between echinoderms and chordates. Because the organisms which comes under this phylum, they exhibit both the characteristic features. The characteristics of these organisms, they resembles the characteristics of both echinoderms and also chordates. One of the example I am going to tell you, that these are echinoderms and the chordates are deuterozoans. Okay, deuterostomes. These are called as deuterostomes. Both echinoderms and chordates, they are considered as deuterostomes. What is the meaning of deuterostomes? Okay, so here the blastopore first develops as anus, okay, during embryonic stage, and then mouth is going to develop. Okay, so that's why these are called as deuterostomes. Echinoderms and the chordates, both are deuterostomes. So this is one of the resemblance we can see both in case of echinoderms and also in the chordates. Okay, so these hemichordates are also deuterostomes. They are also deuterostomes. Hemichordates are also deuterostomes. Okay, so that's why these are the connecting link between the echinoderms and the chordates. They are considered as connecting links between echinoderms and the chordates. Okay, see, this is about the general characteristic feature of the phylum Hemichordata. See, here you are going to remember some unique characteristic features. Those are, these are worm-like organisms, and in the earlier stages they are considered as subphylum of Chordata, but nowadays it kept under separate phylum in the invertebrates or in the chordates. Okay, these are worm-like and they are having different parts in their body, anterior part proboscis, and the middle one is called collar, and the next region is called as trunk region. Trunk region, it has an opening in the posterior end that is called as anus. So because of the presence of mouth and the anus, these worms have complete digestive system. Okay, respiration is through gills. Gills are present in the branchial region, so that's why branchial respiration we can see in these organisms. Excretion, it is through proboscis gland. It acts as glomerulus and it is responsible for the excretion of waste products from the body. Okay, and here hepatic region is found. It contains some hepatic glands. Okay, and abdominal region is found in the trunk part. Okay, and circulatory system is open type. It contains some more developed blood vessels. Okay, and blood flows through these blood vessels and they open into the spaces called as lacuna. Okay, so this is one of the unique characteristic feature we can see in these organisms. And then nervous system. So nervous system, it resembles both the non-chordates and also the chordates. They contain ganglia and the nerve fibers like structures. Okay, and the reproduction, sexual means of reproduction we can see in these organisms. And fertilization is external, development is indirect, and it is having a larval stage called as tornaria. Okay, so this is about the important features and general features of the phylum Hemichordata. One more thing you are going to remember, that is this phylum, it is considered as connecting link between echinoderms and chordates, because these worms are these organisms resembling both the characteristic feature of echinoderms and the chordates. But example I am going to take you that presence of, that means these are also deuterostomes. Echinoderms are also deuterostomes, chordates are also deuterostomes, and these hemichordates are also deuterostomes. Okay, so that's why these are, so because of so many reasons also, because of so many characters that resembling both the phylum, so that's why these are considered as the connecting link between echinoderms and chordates. Okay, in the next class we will study about the phylum, that is chordates. So till now we studied about the invertebrates, or they are called as non-chordates. Non-chordates means they do not contain a solid dorsal notochord. Notochord is absent in these organisms, in the dorsal region of the body. Okay, but in the next class we are going to study about the chordates. They contain notochord in their dorsal region. Okay, and that is going to be develops as vertebral column. Okay, during their development, during the development of organisms, the notochord develops as vertebral column. So these are phylum, they do not contain any notochord. Okay, and what we are going to study in our next class is, that is chordates, they contain notochord. Okay, so that is the phylum we are going to study in the next video. Okay, thank you.